will Dash be able to control his visions at all, or is it going to be overwhelming?
He has a limited ability to control it. So what I mean is, when it's a murder, it overcomes him, and he has to literally find somewhere to hide so that people don't wonder why this guy's having a convulsion. But little things throughout the day, little things like somebody dropping a tray somewhere, or which elevator's going to open, he gets a little twitch, and he knows that's going to happen. So it's all based on the proximity to him. And there are moments in the show where I have to revisit my vision in order to sort of continue the journey of solving the crime. So there's a little bit of control, but not a lot.
The producers talked about, and if I could ask you to speak up a little bit because it's loud.
Okay.
Yes.
The producers talked about meeting with experts on what technology is going to be like at that point. How did that impact what you did? What did you think of what they were looking at?
I mean, we have a lot of really interesting things. Like, on the smaller side, there was a selfie drone, which is actually something that's being created right now, where you'll see in the show, it comes off of a kid's wrist and goes up in the air and takes pictures, like selfies of all these kids. And so that's something that's being created. We also have something that Mr. Spielberg came up with called a smart gun. And that gun actually runs your information and makes a choice about what kind of bullets, or if it's going to use the air gun. So
what kind of target it's looking at?
Yeah.
If it's a threat or not.
Right.
You know,
if that person has a record, all that stuff. So there's a lot of really interesting things in the world coming out of it.
It's exciting for us. You know, we're learning this as we go. All we've shot so far is the pilot.
Yeah.
And it's exciting to know that we have an opportunity as a show to predict the future in a very, from a standpoint of science and fantasy. You know, all the things that they're inventing for the show are based in science, and they're feasible inventions that may not happen next year, but they very much could happen in 50 years.
What he was saying was really interesting is, like, you know, with Tom Cruise doing the whole visual thing there, that literally is an iPhone. That's literally what you're doing, you know what I mean?
The story is that after seeing the movie and Tom Cruise swiping all those images left and right, Steve Jobs saw the film and said, I want to use that, let's make that real. And that's how we have swiping technology on our phone. So it's pretty neat to know that there's a legacy of being innovative and predicting the future, if you will.
Well, were you really familiar with the movie, and did you think to yourselves, this needs a TV show made off of it?
You know, when I saw it, when it was pilot season and I was auditioning for the pilots that I was auditioning for, I saw this and I thought, that's really cool. And I was really excited to find out that it wasn't just a reboot, it wasn't just a reimagining or following the same character that you knew from the movie. It follows, and it's not something completely different, it follows sort of the background characters, you know, which I always love. And so I would say it's a sequel, it's more of a spin-off, in a way. You know, I'm really excited to be a part of it, and even just to be in the room auditioning for it was a thrill.
Are you glad you didn't have to shave your head?
I do, though. I mean, I have to shave it shorter than this. I'll do whatever, man. I'm working for Steven Spielberg. You tell me what to do.